So the answer is 0101010. Let me explain why. So remember that we're using CVC mode encryption. The value of ciphertext block I is the result of encrypting using the key. The value of ciphertext block I minus 1 XORed with message block I. For the first block of the second message, well, that's going to be C0 prime. It's the result of encrypting the value of the previous block, and this was the initialization vector for the first block. For this one, it's the last block in the previous message. So that was the block we called CN minus 1, and that's XORed with message block 0. So here's the danger. The adversary actually knows this value. So that means the adversary can pick a message value, so the value of C0 prime reveals something. That means it has to be an input to the encryption. We're assuming the adversary can't break the encryption, but it has to be an input to the encryption that the adversary already knows what the expected result is. So the adversary knows the encryptions of all the blocks in the previous message, and we know from the way CVC worked, if we want to learn the value of M4, well, M4 was encrypted in the original message using the value here. This was ciphertext 3, the previous ciphertext block, and that was encrypted, and it produces output ciphertext block 4. So that means if we can feed in to this result, that means if we can make the value of this equal to the result of C3 XORed with M4, well, we don't know M4, but we can make it our guess for M4. So we're going to XOR it with our guess for M4. If that's the input to the encryption function, well, then we'll be able to look at the output and see if it matches C4. So to make that the input, well, we have this IV, which is really the last block in the previous message. Well, we can just XOR that out. So what we're going to pass in is the guess XORed with the known value of C3 XORed with this value. With the values I've chosen, well, C3 is this. M star is all zero, so we don't need to worry about that in the XOR. And N minus one, the last ciphertext block, is all the ones. So that's going to flip the first 4 bits. That's why we get this value. And let's see what happens when that value is used for M0. What we're going to get for ciphertext block 0 is the result of encrypting the known value of ciphertext block N-1 with this result, which is C3. Well, now this is XOR, so that same values cancel out. And so that means the result is the result of encrypting C3 XOR with M star. Well, that's the same as we were doing here, right? That's encrypting M4 XORed with C3. We know what C3 is, so we could construct this message to pass in. We don't know what M4 is, but we know if this result is the same, well, then this should be the same as ciphertext block 4. And that would give us the answer to the question, was M4 equal to M star? And of course, we can generalize this. If we can pick the value of M0 prime to be the XOR of the last ciphertext block and the one before the one we want to guess and our guess, that means what we learn, if the ciphertext block that results from the new message is equal to ciphertext block I, then we know that block MI is equal to M star.